वेलकम स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी स्टडी द मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ रूट। मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ रूट मीन्स दैट द रूट्स आर चेंजेस और स्पेशली चेंजेस टू परफॉर्म देयर फंक्शंस एंड सो दैट दे मॉडिफाइड इन देयर सिस्टम, सो इट इज नोन एज अ modification of roots. There are initially we study the modification of tap root. Number one, in diagram we see the fusiform root. Fusiform root, when the root is swollen in the middle and gradually tapering towards the apex and base, being more or less spindle shape in appear, it is said or it is known as a fusiform root. For example, radish is the example of fusiform root. Number second one is the, that is the napiform root. When the root is considerably swollen at the upper part, become almost spherical in shape and sharply tapering at the lower part, it is said to be napiform root. For example, beetroot or turnip roots are also known as a napiform roots. Then the number third one is the, in diagram we see that the fleshy tap root, or that is known as a conical roots. When root is broad at the base and it is gradually tapered towards the apex like cone and looks like cone, it is known as a conical root. For example, that is the carrot root is the example of conical root. And number fourth one is the tuberous root. Tuberous root, in diagram fourth we see the tuberous root, that is the root is thick and fleshy but does not maintain particular shape, it is known as a tuberous root. For example, 4 o'clock plant is the example of tuberous root. Then we study the modified adventitious root. In diagram we see the there are different modified adventitious root, that is the number one, tuberous or tubercular root. Tuberous roots are swollen. In diagram first we see the tuberous root. Tuberous roots are swollen root without any definite shape, whether tap or adventitious, and it is produced as a single, not in cluster, that is known as a tuberous or tubercular root. For example, sweet potato. Now in second diagram figure we see the fasciculated roots. When tuberous roots are occurs in cluster, is known as the base of stem, is known as fasciculated roots. For example, asparagus plant roots are the example of. Number third one is the, in diagram we see the nodulous root. Nodulous root, that is the, when the slender root become suddenly swollen at or near the apex, it is said or it is known as a nodulous root. We see in this diagram, for example, mango, ginger and turmeric are the examples of nodulous root. Then we see fourth one is the muniliform roots or bedded roots. When there is some swelling in the root frequent interval, that is known as a muniliform or bedded roots. For example, Indian spinach is the example of muniliform roots. Number fifth one is the annulated root. The roots are developed in a series of rings like swelling on the body. It is known as annulated roots. For example, Epiac plant is the example of annulated roots. Number 6.1 is the prop root. Prop roots, when the roots are arise from the branches and grow vertically downward direction, and it is penetrate till it comes in contact with soil. These roots are prop, known as prop roots. For example, banyan tree and rubber plant tree also produce this type roots on their branches. Number next one is the stilt root. Stilt root, that is the roots are arise lower nodes of weak stem and grow downward till they penetrate into the soil. Generally, they get shorter and act as a pillar like supporting to the main stem and branches, is known as a stilt root. The such roots are found in plants like maize, sugarcane, jawar are the example of stilt. Next one is the in diagram we see the climbing roots, that is the climbing plants like pepper, for example beetle, black pepper, produce the roots from their node and from the internode by the means of themselves attach their support and it climb, is known as a climbing roots. The number next one is we see the sucking roots. The parasites develop on certain kinds or certain types of plant roots which penetrate into the tissues of the host plant and suck their food. It is known as sucking roots. They are sucking the host from host plant, for that is absorb the food from it and it make a development. These roots are known as the sucking roots. For example, Cuscata is the example of sucking roots. Number next one is the respiratory roots. In diagram, we see the respiratory roots. That is the plant, in these roots are also found in aquatic type plant which are floated, which branches which are floated on the surface of water. That branches develop the special kind of adventitious roots which are soft, light and looks like as a spongy. They are colorless and they are usually developed above the surface of water and serve as a store the air or gases. So it is known as a respiratory roots. For example, Jussieu repens is the example of respiratory root. Then the number one next, epiphytic roots. In diagram we see the epiphytic roots. These roots are found on certain types of kinds of plants, that is commonly in orchid, which grow on the branches of tree. Such plants are known as epiphytic roots. For example, venda is the example of epiphytic roots. They are non-parasites, so insect for sucking of roots. They develop special kind of aerial roots which hang freely in the air. These roots are known as epiphytic roots. These roots are developed specially kinds in aerial root. They are hang or they hang freely in the air. Each root surrounded or covered by spongy tissues called as a velamen. Velamen is known as a typically covering another structure, and with the help of this velamen, the hanging roots are absorb the moistures from the air. Then next one is the assimilatory roots. Assimilatory roots, the branches are climbing on neighboring trees, produce a long slender hanging like roots which are developed the chlorophyll from the green, and they are green color. These green roots are known as assimilatory roots. These roots are absorb carbon dioxide from the air and manufacture the carbohydrates from the air into the air. Then next one and last one is the breathing roots. Breathing roots, it is the modified branch root of the plant. Many plants are grow near the seashore and salt like or poorly poor drain soil, that is known as mangrove plants, develop the special kinds of root called as a respiratory root. Such roots are grow from the underground roots of the plant but arise vertically upward and comes out from the water. So they are looks like as a conical spikes are also produced. For example, Sonoretia is the example of breathing roots. So student, we study the different types of modification in roots, that is the taproot, modified taproots, and next one is the, that is the adventitious root modification. So we study next topic, next point in our next video. Thank you, student.